Hello students, welcome to Saurabh sir classes. This is in continuation to our previous video on solving the chemistry paper for JEE Main exam held on 9/1/2020 in the first shift. We have already discussed few questions on this of this paper, and now we are again starting with the solution of this remaining questions. Now our first question is compound P which on treatment with methyl magnesium bromide followed by acidification and followed by concentrated sulfuric acid and heat, we are getting a intermediate compound which on treatment with ozone and zinc by ozonolysis we are getting the compound this compound. Now this starting compound P gives positive iodoform test, so that means if it is giving positive iodoform test, so this must contain a ketomethyl group. This group should be present in the molecule, and now we have to find out which is the starting material P. Now we see that in all these four cases there is a ketomethyl group, but the if we consider the reaction we will find that in the initial stage there must be aldehyde group, which is aldehyde or ketonic group, where methyl magnesium bromide is attacked, and where they followed by acidification and concentrated treatment of concentrated sulfuric acid, this alcohol is produced, and finally the elimination of water gives a alkene derivative, and which further ozonolysis gives the gives this compound, because ozonolysis of alkene gives the two aldehyde, two carbonyl compounds, better to say, whether it may be aldehyde or it may be ketone. Now the so we can consider the reaction like this way. This on treatment with CH3 MgBr and number 2 H3O plus, this gives us I told you that this will be Mg will be added here, and this methyl will be added here, and MgBr will be added here. So this oxygen will, this bond will be opened in this way, and this methyl group, this will attack here. So we will get this compound, and this compound on acidification followed by heating, this gives us this compound. This compound, there is a ring closure. There is the elimination of water from this hydrogen and this OH. Here is one hydrogen, and this water elimination, this ring closure takes place. Now this on ozonolysis, this on ozonolysis followed by zinc treatment of zinc and water. That is, ozonide is formed first and then it is hydrolyzed to give the carbonyl compound, and we are getting this compound. Here this ozonolysis takes place in here and we are getting this compound. So on ozonolysis, this portion will be converted to ketone and this portion will be converted to aldehyde, and this dimethyl group is present here. So we get this compound, this is our product, this is our product here given. So we are getting from this starting material to this our final desired product. So the correct option is 2. So 2 is the correct option. Our next question: given a solution of nitric acid of density 1.4 gram per liter and 63% weight by weight, determine the molarity of HNO3 solution. Now, to solve this, we see that this solution strength of HNO3 solution. That is equal to 63% weight by weight. So 63 gram of solution contains 100 gram of solution contains 63 gram of this HNO3. Now the molarity of the solution, that will be 63 into 1.4 by 63 into 100 into 1000 mole per liter. Here the molar mass of HNO3, that is equal to 63 gram. So we are getting how much amount of nitric acid is present per liter of the solution. So we can do by dividing the volume multiplying the volume with density, and from there we are getting per liter how much amount of nitric acid is present, and dividing per liter of nitric acid by its molar mass, we are getting the number of moles present per liter, and this comes to 14 mole per liter. So this is answer is 14 mole per liter. Our next question: determine the amount of NaCl to be dissolved in 600 gram water to decrease the freezing point by 0.2 degree centigrade. Given KF of water is 2 per Kelvin per mole and density of water is 1 gram per ml. Now, from the formula, we know that delta Tf, from the formula of depression of freezing point, we know equal to I into Kf into M. Here, this I is the Van't-Hoff factor. Van't-Hoff factor equal to I, the which we have require, which we required here, because NaCl is a electrolyte. It is dissociating in water. So now, for NaCl, we know that this value of I is equal to 2, because it NaCl is dissociating Na plus Cl minus. So, two ions are produced, and Kf is given, value of Kf is given equal 2 Kelvin per mole, M inverse. And we know, if we consider that W gram of NaCl is required, then 600 gram from the definition of molality, we have 600 gram of water contains W gram of NaCl. So, 1000 gram of water contains W by 1000 into 600, sorry, W by 600 into 1000, this much of gram. And per mole, since molar mass of NaCl that is equal to 58.5, so we get 0.2, final equation becomes 0.2 equal to 2 into W by 58.5 into 1000 by 600. So, from here we get W equal to 0.2 into 58.5 into 600 by 1000 into 4, that is equal to 1.2 into 58.5 by 40. So, this comes to 1.76 gram. So, our answer is we required 1.76 gram of NaCl. So, what we did is that we take that amount of sodium chloride required is W. So 600 gram water contains W gram of NaCl, so 1000 gram of water contains this much of NaCl, and this gram weight per gram divided by molecular weight of NaCl, that gives the molality of this solution. So by putting the value of I, Kf and M, and delta F value is known, we can from where we get the value of W. So value of W is coming to 1.76 gram. Our next question is, determine the degree of hardness in terms of ppm of CaCO3 for 10 to the power minus 3 molar of magnesium sulfate dissolved in aqueous medium. Now we see that magnesium sulfate, that is 10 to the power minus 3 molar, that is equal to 10 to the power minus 3 moles of MgSO4 present in 1 liter of solution or 1 liter of water. Now number of CaCO3 will be equal to number of moles of calcium carbonate equal to moles of magnesium carbonate, because both are bivalent, magnesium sulfate, both calcium and magnesium are bivalent. So we can say the ppm of magnesium sulfate in terms of CaCO3, that is equal to ten to the power minus 3 into 100 by 1000 into 10 to the power 6 for ppm level. So ppm in terms of CaCO3 is equal to 100 ppm. So we can say that the degree of hardness in terms of calcium carbonate is 100 ppm. Our next question is, on passing a particular amount of electricity in a GNO3 solution, 108 gram of silver is deposited. What will be the volume of oxygen in liter liberated at 1 bar and 273 K by same quantity of electricity? So we know that atomic mass of Ag, that is equal to 108. Atomic mass of Ag is 108. Now an amount of Ag deposited is 108. So we can say that number of moles atom of Ag deposited that is equal to 108 by 108, that is equal to 1 mole. Now, from the equation we see Ag plus plus electron, that gives us Ag solid. Now, 1 Faraday charge is required to deposit 1 mole of Ag. 1 Faraday charge is required to deposit 1 mole of Ag. Now, from water we get half O2 plus 2H plus plus 2 electron. So, this is the half equation for water during electrolysis. Now, from this equation we see that 2 Faraday charge deposit half mole of oxygen, half mole. And so 1 Faraday charge deposit 1/4 mole. So volume of oxygen VO2, that is equal to nRT/P, that is equal to 1/4 into 0.08314 into 273/1. This is 1 bar. That is equal to 1/4 into 22.7. And that is equal to 5.675 liter. So this much amount of oxygen will be evolved when this same amount of charge, that is this charge corresponding to 1/4 mole, if it is passed through this water, then this 5.675 liter of oxygen will be liberated. So this is why, once again repeat this, that from the first part we see that since 108 gram of silver is deposited and the atomic mass of silver is also 108, so number of moles of silver deposited is 108 by 108, that is 1 mole. And we see from the equation that for deposition of 1 mole, 1 Faraday charge is required. Similarly, in case of water, we see that from water to oxygen, if we go for this ion electron method balancing, that requires 2 electron. Now, this 2 electron corresponds to half mole of oxygen. That is, for passing 2 Faraday, 2 electron is equivalent to 2 Faraday. 2 Faraday, we are getting half mole of oxygen. And for 1 Faraday, we are getting 1/4 mole. So, 1 Faraday is passed here. So, for passing 1 Faraday, we are getting 1/4 mole of oxygen, and that volume of that oxygen is found from PV equal to nRT to 5.675 liter. And our next question is the find the percentage nitrogen by mass in histamine. Now, if we see the structure of histamine, this is the structure of histamine, and the molecular weight of histamine is 111, and this histamine contains 3 nitrogen atoms, and weight of 3 nitrogen atom is weight of 3 N atom. That is equal to 3 into 14. 14 is the atomic weight of nitrogen. So, that is 42. So, we can say that 42 gram or 42 part of nitrogen present in 111 parts of histamine. It will be just reverse. 111 parts of histamine contains 42 parts of nitrogen. So, 100 parts of histamine contains 42 by 111 into 100. So, that is equal to 37.84%. So, this is the percentage of nitrogen in histamine. So, we have just finished all the questions that were available in JEE Main held on 9 January 2020, and this we have solved all these 25 questions, and hope you have understood all these questions and all these solutions, and thank you for viewing this video.